Hello friends, welcome to our channel Kids Moral Story.
So today we are going to tell you the story of the Kingdom of Fools.
The Kingdom of Fools. Rama Chacha, you must be very intelligent. You know so much about farming, fishing, stories and so many other things. Meenu remarked that night as they sat outside watching the fireflies twinkling all around them. But Rama Chacha did not agree. No, not really. There is plenty I still don't know. In fact, one can never stop learning. Knowledge is only the only thing it's good to be greedy about. Rama Chacha is talking about, we must be greedy about knowledge. If you
must not greedy about that thing that money, you want.
Money or power. The more you will be knowledgeful, the more you will be rich. It was a beautiful clear night. The moon and stars shone in the black unpolluted sky. Peerambi was feeling very happy. Her own grandchildren lived so far away and came to visit her only once in 2 or 3 years. After so long, the house was filled with laughter and young voices. She was too faint to do much and was enjoying sitting among them and talking to them. Soon they started yawning and rubbing their eyes, but no one was going to bed till Rama Chacha told another story. The Kingdom of Fools. There once lived a king who was very intelligent. He looked down upon anyone he thought was dull. He was also very proud about the fact that in the kingdom there were no stupid people.
Some distance away from the capital city lived an old teacher. He had taught the young prince, who was a sweet-natured boy, but once had it turned into a proud and rude king. How many people told him about the king's boastful nature? The teacher recited to his old pupil a lesson he would never forget. He called his 3 best, brightest and brightest students,
Mahesh and Umesh,
and said, "We need to bring that proud king down a peg or two. I want the 3 of you to teach him a lesson and make him realize the foolishness of his pride." The 3 students set off the capital. Harish walked to the city market. There he met a man selling beetle leaves. "How much for these leaves?" he asked. 10 rupees for 200 leaves," the shopkeeper replied. "Here, 10 rupees. Give me only 25 leaves, please. My servant will come and collect the balance of 175 leaves." The beetle seller agreed and gave Harish 25 leaves. Harish now strolled into another shop where beautiful shawls were being sold. "How much for these?" he asked, fingering the best shawl in the shop. 200 rupees," answered the shopkeeper. "Here, 25 rupees. You can collect the remaining 175 rupees from the pawn shop there. Harish said, handing the shopkeeper a note. That means Harish had fooled two shopkeepers. First shopkeeper, he said that my servant will come and take 25 betel leaves. And this shopkeeper he fooled like he will give you
shawl seller
25 rupees, not betel leaves, rupees. You
please give the person who brings this note the remaining 175. The note read, the shawl shop owner sent his servant with the note to the pawn shop to verify if indeed it was true. The other shopkeeper glanced at the note and said, yes, it's true. I have to give him 175 more. Come back in half an hour. I will count and keep them ready. The servant returned and whispered to his master. Indeed, the betel leaf seller was going to give them the remaining 175. Harish walked out with the shawl. After half an hour, when the servant went to collect the money, he found the shopkeeper busy counting the leaves.
173, 174, 175. There you go. Here are the rest leaves.
The servant was amazed at being handed a sheaf of palm leaves instead of money. He called his master and the two shopkeepers and started arguing loudly. Slowly they realized that someone had made fools of them. They rushed to complain the king. The king was surprised to hear how a stranger had tricked the clever shopkeepers of his kingdom. He decided to keep a lookout for this man. The next day, Mahesh walked into the royal carpenter's shop. It was the middle of the afternoon and carpenter was in the shop tinkering with some strange looking instruments. Mahesh was well dressed, so the carpenter thought he was rich. Enthusiastically, he started showing off his various creations. He picked up a large wooden lock and said, see this, will you believe that with this you can even lock a man, especially robber? Place the person's head between the lock and a pillar and turn the key, and there the man cannot escape. Mahesh pretended not to be skeptical. Go on now. How can a simple wooden lock do such a thing? I don't believe you. The carpenter got very agitated. But it's true, sir. I am the king's carpenter after all. I create many complicated instruments for the state. Here, let me show you. Saying this, he put the lock around his neck at the nearest pillar and turned the key. Now see, I cannot even move my neck. Are you convinced? Now just turn the key the other way to set me free. But Mahesh would not turn the key. He just stood there laughing. Then he coolly picked up the key and walked out of the shop. The carpenter could only shout at Mahesh, retreating back. You villain! Come back! Set me free! But it was in vain. Mahesh had fooled him again. Later that evening, the king came to know of this other stranger who had dubbed his clever carpenter. He was worried. Who were these men making the brightest people of his kingdom look stupid? He decided to go around the city in disguise to try and catch them. As he walked near the city gates, he found a man sitting there with a heap of mangoes waiting for someone to buy them.
The fruit seller had chosen the loneliest path, which has nothing to hide or to eat, to stay there, or neither any animal was there. Loneliest path. The king was suspicious. "Why are you selling your fruits here?" he asked the fruit seller. "Actually, Umesh," he pretended to look nervously around and answered in whisper, "Sir, I have heard there are some clever thieves roaming around the kingdom waiting to cheat us and our clever king. I have heard one will be walking by his way soon. So I am waiting here hoping to catch him and deliver him to the king." The king was surprised. "That is the person knew all about the clever gang of thieves. Have you seen him before?" "Yes, sir. I know the gang. The person who is coming today is the chief. What does he look like?" "He's tall, hefty, and very cruel." "Is there any way I can see him?" the king asked.
Excitedly.
"Sir, the best way is to hide as soon as he comes. I will whistle and you can see him. But at the spot there was neither a tree nor any rock behind which the king could hide. Then the fruit seller held out a sack. "Hide in this, sir," he suggested. "I will keep you next to me and anyone will think it is a sack of mangoes." The king agreed and hopped into the sack. Quickly, Umesh tied and walked away laughing. The king soon realized he had been tricked, but he was in the sack and could not do anything. Many hours later, when the soldiers came to looking for him, he managed to...
Where is king? Where is gone?
How embarrassed he was.
Embarrassed
to be set free by them. He also knew that he and the people of his kingdom were not as clever as he loved to boast. He realized his mistake.
The king's old teacher came to the court and explained how his three students had tricked everyone. Harish, Mahesh and Umesh apologized for their actions and king promised to rule his kingdom with wisdom and humility. So friends, write in comments, name the three brightest students who were tricking and cheating. Write in comments. What is the meaning of skeptical?
The meaning of skeptical is having a doubt that a claim or statement is true or that something will happen. What is the meaning of cruel?
The meaning of cruel is having a desire to cause pain and suffering. Sentence: you must not cruel to be animals. It's very bad.
Yes. So friends, subscribe to our channel,
hit the notification bell
and press the like button.
Bye.